It's time for the Family Feud Battle of the Television Hosts. Introducing the heavenly hosts, Bert Parks, Tom Kennedy, Jim Lange, Peter Marshall, and Leslie Uggams. And now, the magnificent MC, Bill Cullen, Nipsey Russell, Bob Eubanks, Betty White, and Jim Perry. Let's start the Family Feud Battle of the Television Hosts. With the star of Family Feud, Richard Dawson.
Thank you. Nice big hand, heavenly host. Right out.
Yeah. Hey, Richard, how are you?
Good to have you here.
I'm glad to see you.
Here's my man here. He's going to introduce us to the panel.
Let's meet everyone. You know, they assume that because we are game show hosts, that each one of us knows the other one.
Well, we don't.
We've seen them. We admire. Now, here's a man that I've watched, admired, met him for the first time today, Tom Kennedy, one of America's best game show hosts.
And a great player right here.
Absolutely.
Thank you, sir.
Also, my next friend is Jim Lange, host of Dating Game, who had the good sense to marry one of my former Miss Americas, Nancy Fleming.
Yes.
I've known her and admired her from afar.
Good.
Magic, you know that. She's a lovely lady, Jim.
That's right.
After I tell you that Peter Marshall has won 5 Emmy Awards, besides that, is one of the most repulsive characters.
Get out of here!
That's because I call him an older fellow.
That's
but
what it was. I really love Peter, and I especially love this beautiful child who's a co-host of Fantasy, Leslie Uggams.
Welcome.
Thank you.
Did a great job, Bill. Big, nice, big welcome now to your rivals, headed by Uncle Bill, the magnificent MC. This is Bill Cullen right out. We've each other many moons.
We have indeed.
May I meet all of the rest.
Speaking of many moons.
Exactly.
Fellow been around almost as many moons as I. He's the host of the juvenile jury.
He is indeed.
Lovely show. His name, Nipsey Russell.
Yes, sir.
The champ of all time.
He's a poet.
Poet, and he's a poet.
He is a poet.
Each day we turn another page. You know you're reaching middle age when your pimples and your rashes turn to wrinkles and hot flashes.
Thank you, Nipsey.
A lot better than pimples and rashes.
Exactly, I agree with you.
Oh, we have a gentleman here who is the host of Dream House, currently flourishing on another network.
Mm-hmm. But doing well.
In spite of all that.
He is
Bob
on this
Eubanks.
Network, Bill. It's on
Mr.
this network.
Bobby. Who's next to Bob Eubanks? So
someone who is, although this person has won an Emmy recently, I've taught her most of the things she knows, have dangled her frequently on my knee.
Oh.
My good one, Betty White.
I love Betty.
And I've seen a lot of moons, too.
Exactly, many moons.
And here is a fellow who not only is a marvelous MC, but they took a poll of all the MCs, and he won it for tall, Jim Perry.
Nice big hand for Uncle Jim.
On our next show, I get to wear the blue jacket.
Okay, that'll be fine. You ready to play?
I'm ready to play.
We will play the feud.
All right.
Let's go.
Again. 100
people surveyed. Top 5 answers on the board. You got to try and get the most popular answer. Here is the question. Name something that ties you down.
A rope.
I would have bet money on it.
Yeah.
I swear to God. I would have bet money.
I rope. Love you, Bert.
Hey, you be right.
No. Uncle Bill.
What now?
Marriage.
Marriage from Uncle Bill, the sage. Marriage?
Yeah.
You have control when you play a pass.
Okay, gang, how you feel? They want to play.
Okay, that's
we
good.
We will play.
You go back and explain rope. And
rope.
We'll find... Well done, Bill, well done. There's something that ties you down.
That ties you down. Some jobs. A job.
Job, sure.
Job! Yeah, why not?
Good game, huh?
Yeah.
There you go.
Sure.
The man?
Well, it's the most wonderful part of it. It's children.
You got it.
Yeah.
Bob is not just another pretty face. Children! Gotta be the one who is. Got it.
Well, I have to say pets.
Say it then.
Pets.
Okay.
Sure. Pets?
I love it when you tease me.
Pets!
Yeah!
My man.
You see, the last couple of days, everybody's been wearing a blue
jacket.
Never mind, I don't want
to. No, I saw where you were coming from.
I would say, but I didn't get that.
I couldn't figure out why, though.
That's true. I would say, in the service.
Something that ties you down?
Being in the service.
Okay, fine.
Army, Navy,
the service.
Right.
The service? No. Although I did have an uncle who was tied down once in the... It was a nasty story.
Service and rope have been taken.
They have. It's the best thing that's happened to you in a long time.
Otherwise, I would have had them in that order. I was seeking service and looking rope. I'm going to say there's any number of things I can say. I'm stalling.
No, not at all.
A hobby.
A hobby?
Certain hobby. Certain.
Take a look. All right. Is there a hobby in the house? No. Nipsey, two strikes, but only one answer left, sir. Something that ties you down.
An unpleasant thought, but illness.
Illness, okay. Fine. If it's there, sir, you got it all. If not, get ready to steal an illness. No, there's $86. Bert, get your heavenly host down here and give me an answer.
How about debts?
Oh, they said debts already.
No, they didn't say debts.
They didn't say debts. You got debts.
Bills?
Bill's debts.
Okay. Family. If that's there, you get the $86, and if not, Uncle Bill gets it. Bills or debts?
Yeah.
Five? A boyfriend?
Yeah.
Although, that is illegal, I think, in several states. 86 to nothing. Let's go. Come on, Nipsey. Prego.
You take.
Long question, so listen. 100 people surveyed, top 7 answers on the board. Here's the question. Most people are nervous when they're learning to drive. Name something else which makes people... Yes.
Getting married.
That doesn't make...
Remember I warned you it was a long question?
Oh.
Most people are nervous when they're learning to drive. Name something else which makes people nervous while they're learning to do it. We're not going to have about 80 people getting married all the time, Uncle Tom. What do you think it is, sir?
Make people nervous while they're learning to do it. Skate.
Skate?
Oh,
skate!
That, I was real nervous on that.
No. Ooh. Jim?
Learning to fly. Pilot. Learning to be a pilot.
Fly? Yeah. Two answers will beat it, Bob. Then something else, apart from driving, that makes people nervous while they're learning to do it. Bob? Give me an answer. Okay. Player pass.
Player pass.
Play, I guess.
Play, they don't know anything.
It's a definite, it's a definite play.
We might as well go for it, right?
All righty.
Okay. Learning a new craft, new job.
Okay. New job?
Oh, hey, very good.
Put it there, pal.
Hello, today.
Hello.
It's nice to have you with us.
Thank
what would you think?
Oh, well, learning to cook would make me nervous. You could poison somebody.
Yeah. Cook! No, first strike.
They weren't that nervous.
Bert.
Rope. No, I'm sorry.
Oh, no.
Learning to take care of small children.
Okay, fine.
Oh,
yeah,
God,
let's say that there.
With a rope.
With a rope. Looking after small children. Not there. Well, that was a goodie. Didn't make our survey. Two strikes.
Makes you nervous when you're learning to do it.
Something else that makes people nervous, apart from driving.
Yeah.
Well, they're learning to do it.
Parachute jumping.
See, that's a good idea.
Yeah.
If that's there, you got it. If not, third strike. Parachute jumping. You got it.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Made me nervous when I first learned skiing. Going down,
right.
Off or anything like that.
Ski.
Oh yeah.
I have a lot of children and grandchildren, and every time I get them into the pool, they get very nervous swimming.
Swimming.
Ah, that's good.
Yes.
All right, if that's there, okay. If not, third strike. Swimming!
Wait, I got it.
Oh, learning to play tennis?
Let's see. All right. What? Well, you can miss a backhand or two, particularly if you're skiing at the same time. Tennis! Third strike, right here, magnificent MC.
No, I know that.
Ooh, $54 right there. You want it?
Yes.
What is it?
Learning to ride a bicycle.
That's a good answer. Riding a bike?
No!
I would have thought $1,000. Wait a minute, Nip, what do you think it is?
I thought it was dance. You get it.
Oh, learning to dance?
Making love.
Number two.
Sexy.
You don't learn that. You're born with it.
No, that's rhythm.
Number six, please.
Damn, what I say?
Honey, if you're born with it, I'm an orphan. We'll be back right after we watch this. 86 there, 54, let's go. Come on.
All right, come on.
Okay. 100 people, one hand please, Jim. 100 people surveyed, top six answers on the board. Here's the question. Name an item you hate to lend people because they never return it.
Yeah. The lawnmower.
The lawnmower. Yeah, it's there. Five answers will beat it.
Your car.
Bob said your car. No. Let's go. Oh, Grand Theft Auto. What are you going to do, player?
We're going to play.
Play.
Okay, come on.
All right.
Oh, we got
an
item you hate to lend to people because they never return it, Peter.
Tools.
You got it. Mm. Tools. Yeah. Oh, I think that was my item. Really good. What is it, Leslie?
Certain clothes. You never get them back if you lend them to your friends.
Yeah. Clothes! Thank you. No!
Okay.
Bert?
I have found that in addition to rope, I hate to lend books.
Yeah.
Very good. Right. I think this is it.
I think you finally got one.
You know what people do, shoot. Books!
Hot dog!
I'm proud of you, Bert.
All right, Mark.
Bert. I'm proud of you.
I'm proud of you, too.
Really?
Thank you.
What excitement that was.
I know.
Well, when was the last time your neighbor brought back that cup of sugar? When you go over to loan them a food item.
So you hate?
Food item.
When you loan them a food item.
John!
Hey!
What item do you hate to lend people because they never return it? Yep.
Well, an item would be money, and that's the thing that most people don't return. Money.
And how?
Money.
Number one.
Now I'm confused. Money. Now I'm worried here.
Don't be worried.
Okay. I really can't think of it. Unless it could be.
3 seconds starting from now, you might word it out.
If you give somebody your dog.
Your dog.
Your dog. They never give your dog, back to me.
Only if you take the dog in
front. The dog has a rope on.
Your dog.
Oh, God.
You were right. You had no answer. What is it?
What about luggage?
Luggage?
You lend people luggage. You know, they're going on a trip and they never come back.
Is there? You got it? If not, third strike, luggage. No.
Okay.
Magnificent MCs. Uncle Bill, what's that number four answer? What do you think it is?
The combined thinking of my group.
Yes.
Umbrella.
An umbrella.
Well, they can't go with it.
Umbrella. Record. 131 to 86. Let's go. Come on. Dollar values are doubled. 100 people surveyed. Top four answers on the board. Here's the question. Name a sport that seems to get more and more violent. Yes, hockey. Hockey.
I say we're going to play.
Good, that's good.
Very nice.
Sport that seems to get more and more violent, sir.
Football.
Football? Bam! What is it, Uncle Bill?
The way they play it now, basketball.
Basketball,
elbows and umbrellas.
Many, many injuries there. Basketball? Not there. It is, true. No, just didn't make our survey. First strike.
Without a doubt, boxing.
Boxing. Yes. Boxing? Yeah.
Sport is going to get more and more violent. Just give me a sport.
Baseball.
Baseball? No. Betty, what sport?
I think maybe tennis.
Tennis.
I was going to say chess. But...
pronunciation to tennis. Tennis!
No! All right, come on. All right,
192, there's enough there to make you the champs.
That's okay. Right.
What about soccer?
Soccer.
Yes, that's it.
Soccer, you'll play for $10,000. If not, you get the 192. Soccer! Foreplay. Wrestling. 278, 131. This should decide it. Let's go. Okay, we've got to move along now. Wish you both luck. Dollar value's a triple. This is going to decide it. 100 people surveyed. Top four answers on the board. Here's the question. Name a bad habit that has serious consequences. Yes.
Picking your nose.
What? What's he doing?
Picking your nose for the roof.
Jack Nicholson, Chinatown.
Picking your nose.
Picking your nose.
Jim. Smoking.
Smoking.
Oh,
that's the truth. You have control. What do you do? Quite fast. Don, they're gonna... How can she look so pretty and talk so dirty? I will read it once. Now, please listen, because this can decide whether you go up and play for $10,000 for your charity. I can't repeat it. When I get to you, you got 3 seconds. Name a bad habit that has serious consequences. 3 seconds, Bill.
Drinking.
Drinking! Yes, sir. 3 seconds, Nipsey.
Narcotics.
Okay. Narcotics!
Yeah!
3 seconds, Bob.
Reckless driving.
Reckless driving's there. You'll play for $10,000. Reckless driving? No. 3 seconds, Betty.
Overeating.
Overeating.
Again, if it's there, you're the champs. Overeating? No. 3 seconds, Jim. You can go for $10,000 if you give me number four. What
I think it is.
A bad habit that has serious consequences.
Overexertion.
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 That's it.
What we call OE.
OE.
Yeah, and PU at the same time.
Yeah.
Well, it's overexertion there. You play for $10,000. If not, Bill and the Magnificent MCs will. Overexertion?
Yeah!
Yeah, exactly. Kleptomaniac is a very bad habit.
Yeah.
I need two people to play for $10,000. Okay, Bill? Bill Betty. Bill Betty, play for $10,000 right after we watch this. Oh, Bob!
Come on, Billy.
15 seconds, please.
Remember the postcard.
Name a regular member of the Tonight Show cast.
Johnny Carson.
Any day of the week.
Sunday.
Something with raisins in it.
Fruitcake.
An occupation that uses a thermometer.
Doctor.
Something pipe smokers use.
Tobacco.
Very good. Very good. Take a look. Regular member of the Tonight Show, kid. You said Johnny Carson. He's about the only irregular one that is on the show, but it sounds like a goodie. Survey said. Any day of the week. You said Sunday. Survey said. Yes, sir.
Wow.
Something with raisins in it. Fruitcake. Something we've been called many times.
Oh, yes.
Survey said 10. You have 87. An occupation that uses the thermometer. Is there a doctor in the feud? Survey said.
Wow.
Something that pipe smokers use. Tobacco. Yeah. Survey said.
I'm so nervous.
Don't be nervous, because Bill came in and got 169. You need 31 points. You get 31, you got $10,000 for your charity. Please remind us those marvelous answers Bill gave us, and then 20 seconds on the clock, please. Here we go, Jim. Name a regular member of the Tonight Show cast.
Johnny Carson.
Try again.
Ed McMahon.
Any day of the week.
Sunday.
Try again.
Saturday.
Something with raisins in it.
Bread.
An occupation that uses a thermometer.
Doctor.
Try again.
Nurse.
something pipe smokers use.
Tobacco.
Dragon.
A tamper.
The thing that, yeah, sure. Right, we all remember the Tonight Show cast. Johnny, of course, was number one. You said, Uncle Ed, we need 31 points, $10,000. Survey said. Won $10,564. The magnificent MCs from the United Negro College Fund and the Special Olympics, $12,091. We got another $10,000 to give away, and next time we all meet right here on the Feud. We love that.